salvation and yes, sir, have mercy upon me. God, we bring you something, yes, sir, have mercy upon me. God, we bring you something, yes, sir, have mercy upon me.
Blessed is our God, always, now, and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord, forgive our sins, master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit in your infirmities for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and Holy Spirit, both now and forever, unto the ages of ages. Amen. Come, let us worship and fall down before the King and our God. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, the King and our God. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, the King and our God. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication, and shoot your truth, answer me. In your righteousness, do not enter into judgment of your servant, for all known living there shall become righteousness in your sight. For yet the enemy has persecuted my soul, he has humbled my life on the ground. He has caused me to dwell in dark places like those long dead. My spirit faints with anguish within me, my heart is troubled within me. I remember the days of old, I meditated all your works. I meditate on your hand, the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you, so my soul thirsts for you like the water's fat. Hear me, speed it, Lord, my spirit faints within me. Turn not your face from me, lest I become like those who down into the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, for I have humbled you. Make me know, O Lord, the where and I should walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for you flee, I flee for refuge. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall guide me in the land of uprightness. For your name's sake, O Lord, give my life. In your righteousness you shall bring my soul out of affliction, and in your mercy you shall destroy my enemies. And you shall utterly destroy all who afflict my soul, for I am your servant.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the servants of God, all those who are present, that the grace of the Holy Spirit may come to them.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we give glory, to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Through you we may be delivered from adversities.
For you are the salvation of the Christian race.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy. And according to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my lawlessness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my lawlessness, and my sin is always before me. Against you only have I sinned, and done evil in your sight, that you may be justified in your words, and overcome when you are judged. For behold, I was conceived in transgressions, and in sins my mother bore me. Behold, you love truth. You show me the unknown and secret things of your wisdom. You shall sprinkle me with hyssop, and I will be cleansed. You shall wash me, and I will be made whiter than snow. You shall make me hear joy and gladness. My bones that were humbled shall greatly rejoice. Turn your face from my sins, and blot out all my transgressions. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with your guiding spirit. I will teach transgressors your ways, and the ungodly shall turn back to you. Deliver me from the guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall greatly rejoice in your righteousness. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. For if you desire a sacrifice, I will give it. You will not be pleased with whole burnt offerings. A sacrifice to God is a broken spirit. A broken and humbled heart God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in your good pleasure to Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with offerings and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer young bulls on your altar.
La, la, la. Master Christ, have mercy on your servants. The unction of compassion ever cheers the souls and the bodies alike of us, your servants. Master, and with oil you protect the believers all. So now to us who come to you through holy unction, be all merciful.
Master, Christ, have mercy on your servants.
cleanse us all. We always run to you with fervent faith and pray to receive your grace. Unction. By your seal now save the suffering are merciful.
Wash away the pain and trauma and suffering.
servants. Give your mighty help and assistance to all who come to you through this sacrament, to be anointed by your priest with holy unction, O compassionate.
Master Christ, have mercy on your servants. We have now behold all with Savior, the holy oil full of gladness, to which more than others you added, by your divine act, O tender loving Master, and which you shared symbolically with all who shared in holy baptism. Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Deity of us, have mercy, O Savior. We deliver us from any peril. Rescue us, your servants, O envoy, for we are
we have dared.
and rid them of all disease. Make them worthy of your delight, which remain incorruptible.
Blessed is the kingdom of God.
the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For Archbishop and Father Sabas, the Honorable Presbyter, for the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the people in attendance who anticipate the grace of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this oil, that it will be blessed by the descent and power and operation of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord. For the servants of God who have come for this holy oil, the holy sacrament, and that God will visit them, and that the grace of the Holy Spirit will come upon them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our God. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
O Lord, in your mercy and bounties, heal the disorders of our souls and bodies. Sanctify this oil, so that those who shall be anointed with it may be healed and freed from every passion, illness of body, uncleanness of flesh and spirit, and from all evils. That in this too your holy name may be glorified. To the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
O Christ, you alone are he who quickly comes to our aid. We pray that you show your quick response from heaven to your servants who are suffering. Free them from their diseases, relieve the pain that afflicts them. Raise them that we may ceaselessly give glory and extol you by the prayers of the Theotokos, only lover of humanity.
In the eyes of the soul,
have I become a seed.
you became the minister of sacred mysteries in Mira, Holy Father Nicholas, fulfilling Christ's holy gospel. You lay down your very soul for your people, and you save those who were innocent from dying. For this reason you were hallowed as a great mystic of the divine grace of God.
Peace be unto all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Let us be attentive.
Empower us also to become ministers of this new covenant
of your Son over this oil, which you have secured through his precious blood, that putting away earthly desires, we may die into sin and live in righteousness, being clothed with our Lord Jesus Christ, through the anointing with his sanctifying oil, which we are about to summon to our aid. Grant that this oil becomes the oil of gladness, the oil of sanctification, a royal robe, an armor of might, the deflecting of every satanic assault, the seal of immunity from snares, the gladness of heart, everlasting joy, that also in this they shall be anointed with this oil of rebirth, may be strong against their adversaries, and may shine in the radiance of your saints, having neither spot nor wrinkle, and that they may be admitted into your eternal rest, and receive the award of the calling from above. For yours it is to show mercy and to save us, O our God, and to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive. Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's letter to the Romans.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, we who are strong ought to bear the failings of the weak, and not to please ourselves. Did each of us please his neighbor for his good, to edify him? For Christ did not please himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of those who reproach thee fell on me. For whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, that by steadfastness and by the encouragement of the Scriptures, we might have hope. May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant you to live in such harmony with one another, in accord with Christ Jesus, that together you may with one voice glorify God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome one another, therefore, as Christ has welcomed you.
Peace be to you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia.
Wisdom, arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be unto all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the holy gospel according to Luke. Let us be attentive. So he ran on ahead and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and said to him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for I must stay at your house today. So he made haste and came down and received him joyfully. And when they saw it, they all murmured, he has gone in to be the guest of a man who is a sinner. And Zacchaeus stood and said to the Lord, Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor, and if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I restore it fourfold. And Jesus said to him, Today salvation has come to this house, since he also is a son of Abraham, for the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost.
Spirit,
now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
and boundless gulf of loving kindness, master who loves mankind, the God of things eternal and of wonders, whom no man can by reason comprehend, look down and hear us, your unworthy servants, and wherever we bring this oil in your great name, send down the gift of your healing and remission of sins, and heal them in the multitude of your mercies. Yes, O Lord, who are easy to be entreated, you alone are merciful and you love mankind. You are sorrowful for our evil deeds. You know how the mind of man leans towards wickedness, even from his youth. You do not desire the death of a sinner, but rather that he should repent and live. For the salvation of sinners, though being God, you became a created being for the sake of your creatures. You have said, I came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. You sought the wandering sheep. You searched diligently for the lost point. And having found it, you said, he that comes to me, I will not cast out. You did not abhor the sinful woman who washed your precious feet with her tears. You said, as often as you fall, get up, and you shall be saved. It is you who said, there is joy in heaven over one sinner who repents. O merciful Master, look down from on high, giving us your sinful and unworthy servants shelter under the grace of your Holy Spirit in this hour, and take up your abode in these your servants, who acknowledge their iniquities and draw near to you in faith. Accept them because of your love toward mankind, forgiving them whatever they have done amiss, whether by word, deed, or thought, and cleanse them from every sin, and abiding ever present with them, preserve them for the remaining years of their life, that walking ever in your statutes, they may in no way again become an object of joy to the devil, so that also in these, your holy name to be glorified. For yours it is to show mercy to save us, O Christ our God, and to you we ascribe glory, together with your Father, who is from out everlasting, and your all holy, good, and life bringing Spirit, now and forever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive. Let us be attentive.
Brethren, you are the body of Christ and the beginning members of it, and God has appointed in the church first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then workers of miracles, and healers, helpers, administrators, speakers in various kinds of tongues. Are all apostles, are all prophets, are all teachers, do all work miracles, do all possess the gifts of healing, do all speak with tongues, you all interpret, but earnestly desire the higher gifts, and I will show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am noisy going, or clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mystery and all knowledge, and if I hope in faith so to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believers in all things. All things and do all things, love never ends.
Peace be to you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be unto all. Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
At that time, Jesus called in his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal every infirmity. These 12 Jesus sent out, charging them, go nowhere among the Gentiles and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And preach as you go, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. of the servants of God, all those present for this holy sacrament, and for the forgiveness of their every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary. God who loves mankind, and to you we send a glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Master, almighty and holy King, who chastens yet does not put to death, who supports those who fall and raises those who are downtrodden, he heals our physical afflictions. We entreat you, our God, that you bring your mercy on this oil and to those who are anointed with it in your name, that it may be effectual unto healing of soul and body, unto cleansing and deliverance from every infirmity, illness, malady, and every defilement of body and soul. Yes, Lord, send down from heaven your healing power. Touch the body, quench the fever, soothe and banish every hidden ailment. Become the physician of these your servants. Raise them up and heal their suffering, that they may be given to the church, whole and in restored health, pleasing you and abiding by your will. For yours it is to show mercy to save us, O our God, and to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, you are the temple of the living God. As God said, I will live in them and move among them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Therefore, come out from them and be separate from them, says the Lord, and touch nothing unclean. Then I will welcome you, and I will be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. Since we have these promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from every defilement of body and spirit, and make holiness perfect in the fear of God.
Peace be to you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, arise, let us hear the holy gospel, peace. Unto all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, glory to you.
At that time, Jesus entered Peter's house. He saw his mother-in-law lying sick with a fever. He touched her hand and the fever left her, and she rose and served him. That evening they brought to him many who were possessed with demons, and he cast out the spirits with a word, and healed all who were sick. This was to fulfill what was spoken by prophet Isaiah. He took our infirmities and bore our diseases. Now when Jesus saw great crowds around him, he gave orders to go over to the other side. And a scribe came up and said to him, Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus said to him, Foxes have holes, and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Another of the disciples said to him, Lord, let me first go and bury my father. But Jesus said to him, Follow me, and leave the dead to bury their own dead. And when he got into the boat, his disciples followed him. Salvation, visitation, forgiveness, and remission of the sins of the servant. and merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. Gracious, loving, compassionate, and ever-merciful Lord, plentiful in mercy and rich in beneficence, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who through your holy apostles have empowered us to heal the infirmities of your people by oil and prayer, confirm this oil unto the healing of those who shall be anointed with it, for the relief of every ailment and every malady, for deliverance from evils of those who in firm hope await salvation from you. Yes, O Master, Lord, our God, we pray to the Almighty that you will save us all, only physician of souls and bodies, sanctify us all, as healer of every malady, heal also these your servants. Raise them up from their bed of pain through the mercy of your goodness. Visit them in your mercy and compassion. Cast out from them every sickness and malady, so that being healed by your mighty hand, they may serve you with all thanksgiving. That even now, sharing in your ineffable love, we may sing praises and glorify you, who do great and wondrous things, both glorious and transcendent. For yours it is to show mercy and to save us, O our God. And to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive.
Do you, Lord, grant and keep us safe from me, O Lord. There is no bodily mind left.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians.
Let us be attentive.
Brother, we do not want you to be ignorant, brother, of the affliction we experienced in Asia. For we were so utterly, unbearably crushed that we despaired of life itself. Why? We felt that we had received the sentence of death, that that was to make us rely not on ourselves, but on God who raises the dead. He delivered us from so deadly a peril, and he will deliver us on him. We have set our hope that he will deliver us again. You also must help us by prayer, so that many will give thanks on our behalf for the blessing granted us in prayer for many prayers.
Peace be to you, the reader. God, all those present for this holy sacrament, for the forgiveness of their every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary. You are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord our God, who chasten and again heal, you lift the indigent from the ground and dunghill. Father of orphans and haven of Pentecost, physician of the ailing, who without toil bears our iniquities and accepts our infirmities. It is you who cheerfully show mercy and pass over iniquity, taking away our unrighteousness. Quick to help and slow to wrath, you breathed on your disciples and said, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. It is you who accept the repentance of sinners and have the power to pardon the countless and grievous sins, bestowing healing upon all who continue in weakness and long enduring illness. It is you, Lord, who have also called me your humble, sinful, and unworthy servant, caught up in my many sins and wallowing in the pleasures of the life, to the holy and exceedingly lofty degree of the priesthood, and to enter within the innermost veil into the Holy of Holies, where the holy angels desire to penetrate and hear the voice of the Lord God announcing glad tidings, and to behold with their own eyes the presence of the sacred oblation, and to enjoy this divine and sacred liturgy. You, Lord, deem me worthy to minister your heavenly mysteries and offer new gifts and sacrifices for our sins and the ignorances of the people, and to mediate for your reason and doubt sheep, so that through your great and inevitable love for mankind, you may blot out their transgressions. All merciful King, hear the voice of my prayer at this hour and at all times and places. And to these your servants who are ailing in soul and body, grant your healing, remitting their sins and pardoning their transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, treating their incurable wounds and every ailment and malady. Give health to their souls. You who touched Peter's mother-in-law, and having been cured of her fever, arose and ministered to you. O Master, grant healing and deliverance from every devastating pain to these your servants. Remember your mercies and compassion, and that the mind of man inclines toward evil from his youth, that no one is without sin upon the earth. You alone are without sin. You came and saved the human race and set us free from the bondage of the enemy. For if you enter into judgment with your servants, none will be found clean from stain, but every mouth shall be sealed, not having any defense, for as discarded rags is all our righteousness before you. Therefore, Lord, remember not the sins of our youth. For you are the hope of the hopeless, the rest of those who are labor and are heaven laden with iniquity, and to you we ascribe glory, together with your Father who is from everlasting, and your all holy, good and life giving Spirit, now and forever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy. Grant me the clean heart of God.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's letter to the Galatians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control, against such there is no law. And those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also walk by the Spirit. Let us have no self-conceit, no provoking of one another, no envy of one another. Brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass, you who are our spiritual should restore him in a spirit of gentleness. Look to yourself, lest you judge. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ.
Peace be to you, the reader.
Alleluia.
Wisdom arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace. Have mercy on me, O Lord, Son of David. My daughter is severely possessed by a demon. But he did not answer her a word. And his disciples came and begged him, saying, Send her away, for she is crying after us. He answered, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But she came and knelt before him, saying, Lord, help me. And he answered, It is not fair to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs. She said, Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered her, O woman, great is your faith. Be it done for you as you desire. And her daughter was healed instantly.
Forgiven them, and if you retain the sins of any, they are retained.
you hearken to Hezekiah in the sorrow of his soul at the hour of his death, and do not overlook his prayer. In like manner, hear me, your humble, sinful, and unworthy servant, praying to you at this hour. For you are the Lord Jesus Christ, who with your mercy and love for mankind commanded us to forgive those who fall into sin, even 70 times 7, who laments over our wickedness and rejoices over the return of those who have strayed. For as is your mercy, so also is your mercy, and to you we ascribe glory, together with your Father who is from everlasting, and your all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever, to the ages, ages. Let us be attentive.
O Lord, do not rebuke in your anger. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am weak.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's letter to the Thessalonians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, we exhort you, admonish the idlers, encourage the faint-hearted, help the weak. Be patient with them all. See that none of you repays evil for evil, but always seek to do good to one another and to all. Rejoice always, pray constantly, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit, do not despise prophesying, but test everything. Hold fast what is good, abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you wholly. And may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Peace be to you, the reader.
I often wondered to myself,
growing up, especially, why is this only done during Holy Week? You know? Why is this only ever done during Holy Week? And why is it put here in this particular place during Holy Week? It's a very interesting set of questions. Now, without going into really, really great detail, I will just tell you, it's not just done during Holy Week. It can be done anytime. It can be done whatever you want it else to know. And in our parish, because we have not been without many sick people throughout my time here, we have found that it is good to do it at least another time during the year in December. So we offer it a couple times a year, separated by a few months, so that we have a little bit of way of really offering the service and allowing it for it to really penetrate our souls. Because we have, again, sick people here in our parish, both in their bodies and some that feel this in their souls as well. So, but why now? Why Wednesday? Why not do it Monday? Why not do it on Sunday? Why not do it on Tuesday? Why not do it on Thursday? These are very interesting questions that we have to ask ourselves. Some of those things, definitely not on Friday or Saturday, just because of the way that the services find themselves kind of packed in there. But this is a very specific day, brothers and sisters in Christ, that this oil is being sanctified specifically on this day. It is a very interesting thing that is happening. And if, as you look at the prayers of this service and you find where we sit on this day, and what we have already prayed for during this week of Holy Week, you will see why it is done on this day. I'll just ask a question. First question. If you get the answer wrong, you'll still get unction, I promise. Okay. What is the remembrance that we have just brought into our minds over the course of the last day? What person have we remembered over the course of the last day within the church during Holy Week? Who is it that we're putting into our brains? When Christ is the whole week, one specific person, not just Christ. That's a good answer. Go ahead. Lazarus was on Saturday. I'm talking about within the last day. Good answer. In fact, last night I read his name actually was in the gospel. What person? Has to do with oil. Have we just remembered? The sinful woman. The sinful woman. She's otherwise known as the harlot. The sinful woman. The person that saw Christ, understood who he was, and sprinted as fast as she could to sell every piece of jewelry, every piece of everything that she had, to buy very expensive ointment so that she could walk up to Christ and kiss and weep upon and anoint and wipe dry his feet. And where was he at this time? In somebody else's house. He was in somebody else's house. Depending on the gospel, he was either in Matthew or Simon the leper, depending on the gospel. Doesn't matter. But he was in somebody else's house. Can you imagine being in your living room with a very important guest? And somebody comes barging right into your door, ignores you, walks right up to your guest of honor and says, and just weeps right on top. If I'm the master of the house, number one, I'm feeling disrespected. Number two, I'm going, what the heck is happening? But this is why this service specifically sits in this week. Because when Jesus saw what happened, when Jesus understood what was taking place, because he could penetrate her soul and see why she needed this, he didn't stop her.
In fact, he asked Simon, let her go. Don't stop her. Let her do this. She's doing this for my burial. This is what's going on. And he said it again this morning in the gospel. Wherever this gospel is preached, what she has done will be honored and offered in remembrance of her. I said it this morning again. We don't even know her name. Didn't have a name. This particular woman does not have a name. She's just known as the sinful woman or the harlot. And yet, anytime the gospel is preached, we're going to hear about it, according to Christ. The significance of this day with holy oil, as we are being anointed, not that Jesus needed to be cleansed, it was the oil that she bought, it was the oil that she brought, it was the oil that she anointed Christ that actually cleansed, in turn cleansed her. Everything that she had done, everything that she stood for, everything that she was about, we would have held her at an arm's length. Let's not fool ourselves. A person of that kind of reputation, we would be cut dead. It's the truth. Even just for fear of what people might say about, look at this person, they're seeking out. This is what would happen. Let's not kid ourselves. In some ways, we should be ashamed of ourselves for that, but at the same time, it's a reality. We have to work. We have to do better. We have to do better. Today, instead of us offering oil to Christ, even though that's what we've done, Christ has sanctified oil and is pouring it on us. And the connotation is clear. According to the scripture, it's for cleansing, it's for healing, but this entire week is all about the remembrance of death. Whose death? Christ, first and foremost, but our death. Because I'll tell you what, whatever it is that is alive in us that is sinful, it's got to die. It's got to die. Whatever it is, it doesn't make a difference. Whatever is alive in us that is sinful or of the evil one, it has to die. And this is how it happens. Communion is how it happens. The sacraments of the church is how it happens. Coming before the Lord with contrition, as the prayers have said, that's how it dies. You are here because something inside of you has to die. Got to get buried. And it has to not get uncovered. So this is what's going on today. This is why this unction is being offered this day. This is why this sacrament is always connected with Holy Week. And on this particular day. Because what happens after this tonight is we start to remember the mystical supper, the trial, the betrayal, the trial, the suffering. We go into the almost the rushed events of Holy Week. This is almost the last chance that we will have to really contemplate anything else except the life of Christ. This is really the last time that we will have an opportunity to really contemplate our own sins within these services. There'll be times for it, but we'll be so focused on what Christ has done, our own sins won't matter as much as when we see His suffering. So today, we are being anointed. And the other reason, by the way, practical reason, open parentheses so that I can close it. The other practical reason why unction was being offered today was because in many traditions of the faith, God bless you, in many traditions of the faith, oftentimes people will have been fasting so that they can receive communion. And sometimes, unfortunately, as you've heard me preach against this practice, this is the only time that they would receive communion almost the whole year. Frequent communion sometimes in our history wasn't happening. And you know I'm a proponent of coming to the chalice more often. But a lot of times, people weren't doing that. They would only come to church, they would only come to communion maybe once or twice a year. They come to church, just not to communion. So unction was another way of preparing themselves to receive Holy Communion. I'll close parentheses. Today, we are about to be anointed. We're going to finish the service and we'll come up for anointing. We're going to have the opportunity to be blessed, and I will speak more about how that blessing will take place as you come forward. But for now, we'll ask you to please rise and we will continue our service. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray that you hear us and have mercy. Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, forgiveness, and remission of the sins of the servants of God, all pious and Orthodox, all the sins of those who are present for this holy sacrament, for the forgiveness of their every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. Master, Lord our God, physician of our souls and bodies, it is you who soothe the chronic pains and heal every infirmity and malady of the people. You desire that all should be saved and come to the knowledge of truth. And you will not the death of a sinner, but rather that he should repent and live. For you, O Lord, in the Old Testament ordained repentance for sinners for David and for the Ninevites, for those before and after them, but also in the new dispensation of your coming in the flesh. You call not the righteous, but sinners to repentance. Let the publican, the harlot, the robber, the blasphemer, and the great persecutor Paul, receiving them all through repentance. Peter, your great apostle, who denied you 3 times, you received in repentance and promised him, saying, "You are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven." Therefore, merciful and loving God, encouraged by your faithful promise, we pray and entreat you at this hour. Hear our prayer and accept it as incense offered before you. Visit these, your servants, and if they have transgressed either in word or deed or thought, by night or by day, if they have come under the curse of a priest or under their own anathema, or have sworn an oath, we pray to you, loose, pardon, and forgive them, O God, overlooking their transgressions and their sins committed by them knowingly or in ignorance, if they have transgressed your commandments or have erred bearing flesh living in this world or by the prompting of the devil, forgive them as a merciful and loving God. There is no man who lives and does not sin. Only you are sinless. Your righteousness is to all eternity, and your word is truth. For you did not create man for destruction, but for keeping your commandments and to inherit life incorruptible. To you we ascribe glory with your Father, who is from everlasting, and all holy, good, and life, and Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages. If at this time there are individuals who are struggling and suffering specifically, we ask that you come forward at this time and kneel under the gospel that I will be holding. Do not be shy. Please come forward. And everyone, if you are not going to come forward to kneel, we would ask you to kneel at this time. Let us pray to the Lord. Holy King, compassionate and most merciful Lord Jesus Christ, Son and Word of living God, who does not desire the death of a sinner, but that they should turn back and live, I do not place my sinful hand on the heads of these who have approached you in sins and who ask from you, through me, forgiveness of sins, but do you stretch out your mighty and powerful hand in this holy gospel, which I hold upon the heads of these your servants. And I beg and implore your compassionate love for mankind, which does not remember evil. O God, our Savior, who through your prophet Nathan granted forgiveness to David of his sins when he repented and received Manasseh's prayer of repentance, do you, in your customary love for mankind, accept as your servants
who repented over their offenses, overlooking all their transgressions. For you are God who commanded us to forgive those who fall into sins unto 70 times 7. Because as your majesty is your, because as is your majesty, also is your mercy to you. We belong in glory, honor, and worship, together with your Father, who has no beginning in your all, holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. Holy Father, the healer and physician of our souls and bodies, you sent your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to heal every infirmity and every disease and to deliver us from death. Heal these your servants from the ailments of body and soul and endow them with life. This we ask by the grace of your Christ, through the intercession of the most pure Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, by the power of the precious life-giving cross, protecting the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, supplicating the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, the holy glorious and praiseworthy apostles, the holy glorious and triumphant martyrs, and the venerable godly ascetic fathers, the holy wonder-working unmercenaries, Cosmas and Damianos, Pierce and John, Samson and Demetrius, Moses and Egyptus, Pantaleon and Menelaus, Galileus and Phaethon, of the holy righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints. For you are God, the source of healing, and to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to your God, glory to you. May Christ, our true God, through the intercession of his all-immaculate and blameless Holy Mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the holy righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, St. James, the Lord's brother, and of all the saints, hear the petitions of us sinners, and have mercy upon us and save us, for he is a good and merciful God and loves mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. May the Holy Trinity bless, protect, and keep all of you. Please be seated. There is a wonderful opportunity, brothers and sisters in Christ, as the tray is being passed. There's a wonderful opportunity that we have to be anointed. Many times, just to make the anointing easier, I'm going to remove this garment here in a second. Many times when we have an opportunity to be anointed, we will take the cotton and kind of like wipe it off. The cotton is only there to kind of dab it so it doesn't like fall into our faces. Things like this, you know, whatever. But when you're anointed, the best thing to do is not even to use the cotton, just rub it in. That's why you're being anointed for healing. Don't take the anointing off. Please don't do that. I will just offer my normal disclaimer that this is, this very much like communion is a sacrament of the Orthodox Church reserved for Orthodox Christians that have been baptized in the Orthodox faith. However, no one that comes into our sanctuary that as long as I am here will ever leave without a blessing. No one. So please, if you have not been baptized Orthodox, please still come forward and make sure that if I do not know this, you tell me because I do have other oil that I bless with and offer a blessing on behalf of the Lord and His Mother on this day. So this is not, no one ever leaves without a blessing. We always make sure that everyone receives that, but, you know, we have to adhere to what we do within the faith. So I will be right there in just a second. Church this evening. I know, come to church twice a day, right? Church this evening is at 6:30. Then tomorrow, I'm not going to make all the announcements for the rest of the week, but then tomorrow at 8 o'clock in the morning, we will have the Vesper Liturgy
of St. Basil, this specific liturgy is the only vestibule, the only liturgy of St. Basil where I invested like this, invested in purple, and it's the institution of the Holy Communion, this is where we hear Jesus say the specific words of the institution of communion at the mystical supper that he offered with his disciples. That's tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock, and then again at 6:30, we will have church for the service of the 12 Gospels, followed by our all-night vigil with whoever, you know, most of the time it's going to be with the joint, but whoever would like to stay is welcome to. So that's what's going on. I'll be with you in just a moment as I prepare for this blessing. One more thing, there will be an opportunity if people would absolutely have to, I mean absolutely have to. This is something that I say every year. I would rather not send any unction out. I would rather be the one going to keep it. So if you absolutely have to, you may take some with you if you have to anoint someone. Please do not let me hear that you're sending this in the mail to somebody. Please. Let's keep the sanctity of this oil and let them come here to receive it. This unction is on the altar table year round. Anyone that needs it, we will have plenty for you. But if you absolutely have to, if there's a vital need, we will have Q-tips and some bags for you over on the side if you need it, and we'll make some available to you. Otherwise, as I got a message earlier today, I need something for so-and-so. Would you like me to have them come to you? I said, yes, please. If they can, come to me. I would rather be that way.
Oh, more